When I am focused on at least a nominal amount of ketones, I feel like my old self. And so that's one. Other things that I focus on or look at, there are some esoteric things that I play with every once in a while, but if you're looking at the routine levels, I'm going to look at, obviously, the sex hormones, but look at free testosterone. I'll look at free testosterone as relative to sex hormone binding globulin, mm-hmm. for instance. Not convinced that higher sex hormone binding globulin is always a bad thing. That's a whole separate, because my testosterone in experimenting with high fat, total testosterone has gone from like 650 to 950 in the span of like 2 months. It's a non-trivial increase. Now, sex hormone, you know, sex hormone binding globulin has also increased over that period of time, but I've gained so much mat, like lean muscle tissue, that I have other ideas. And I was talking to Stephen Finney about this, scientist very well known for looking at the ketogenic diet, and what he was saying is independent of insulin levels, insulin being very anabolic, sorry, we're getting into the weeds here, but it's possible that my lean mass gains can be accounted for by decreased degradation of branched chain amino acids. Mm-hmm. And I was like, that's really interesting, because then that maybe that explains why fasting plus chemotherapy is very, very effective, for instance. People can recover faster from chemotherapy. So you have the ketones, you have the sex hormones, hemoglobin A1C, sort of like your running 3 month average of glucose levels, just as an insurance policy to ensure that I'm not skewing towards pre-diabetic in any way. And then a laundry list of like five or six different pages. Yeah.
So your biomarkers tend to be a lot of performance related biomarkers.
I think.